What's up, guys? Saxon, the Good Time Gaming, and we are playing Titanfall 2 today. I'm going to play the campaign mode. I've been playing a little bit of the campaign already, and I've really, really enjoyed what I have been doing so far. It's been really awesome. It's been a great experience. So we're going to head right into it and just get this thing going. I've been playing multiplayer some. I have to say, I've really, really had fun with this game. The first Titanfall was amazing. I loved it, but I kind
of
lost interest pretty quickly, unfortunately.
The battlefields of the frontier.
It's a pretty cool cutscene here.
Is the true dominant.
The problem that I have with like competitive FPSs is that I tend to lose interest in them very, very quickly, which is what happened with like Battlefield 3, Battlefield 4, Titanfall. I mean, you name it, any FPS I pick up that's like more competitive in nature, I tend to lose interest in very quickly. So I'm hoping not to have that happen with Titanfall, because I've really enjoyed it a lot. It's just very different from anything else on the market. It's very enjoyable.
Sheer
for
walls
sure.
Become flanking routes.
I think EA definitely hit it out of the park this year with FPSs, because they have Titanfall coming out, which is like this fast-paced, futuristic, hardcore, mecha,
even overwhelming
shooter.
Shift in their favor.
And they have Battlefield 1. Or whatever it's called, yeah. Battlefield 1, I think? Yeah.
But what truly separates the
pilot is, you know,
from all the grunts and
World War
One, battlefield,
old style guns and shit like that. So cool.
A pilot and a Titan.
Boom. Yeah, so far everything with this game has just been fantastic.
When linked to a Titan, a pilot can only be stopped by overwhelming force or an equal.
Ronin.
The frontier has been the only home I've ever known. For years, our lands have been destroyed by the IMC, forcefully taking our resources.
I feel like you played as the IMC in the first game. Maybe I'm wrong about that. I don't really remember the first game's campaign, to be honest, which is kind of bad. But I mean, that's just kind of what was bad about the first game campaign, is it was so forgettable.
A long way to go.
It was just like,
the IMC is defeated.
I don't know, shit's going on. Care about it, but you don't care about it.
No,
it's just like a,
I serve as a
multiplayer simulator is all it was.
Fighting to free the frontier.
You know, it was just basically there to get you ready for multiplayer, and not really to like give you any narrative or to
when that day
make you invested at all in it.
I hope I can live up to the honor.
Which was a big problem I felt with the first game. So hopefully not with this one. From what I've played so far, I've been very impressed with the single player campaign. Not a throwaway campaign by any means. Has very good flow and cohesion to it. I probably honestly made it through half the campaign, and I wasn't originally going to do this game at all on the channel. But then I thought, you know what, I really want to put something else up on the channel besides Payday stuff and have something consistent going that kind of fits with the channel anyways. I've been playing a lot of Final Fantasy 14, which is an MMO, so it doesn't really fit that well with what the channel already has on it. So I figured, you know what, an FPS is cool. This is something new and interesting to put on there. And hopefully some of you guys out there watching this actually play Titanfall 2. That'd be pretty amazing on PC anyways, so that I have... someone else to play with.
Right.
Certainly have anybody to play with right now on PC.
Let's see how much you remember from last time. Setting the neural link. Not quite the same as a Titan link, but it's similar.
So this part is very rehearsed. Basically just like tutorial. Kind of wish we could skip it, but it's actually not terrible for a tutorial. It's kind of interesting, sort of.
Ah, much better.
Captain?
Technically, I'm not supposed to be training you, but in you I see potential. Besides,
in the face. In the face.
Who's got
in the face.
Classes, right? Here you go, up and over. Let's pick up the pace, enabling jump kit assist.
Yeah.
Jump kits operate on the principle of relaxed stability. Once your jump kit calibrates to your movement style, enhanced mobility becomes second nature. Beautiful, isn't it?
If you guys hear some meowing soon, it's the cat being a dildo, basically.
Good, now you're moving.
I just love the movement in this game. It's so good. So crisp.
Simple double jump. Follow the ghost.
Man, fuck the ghost. I got this shit.
We've retaken over a quarter of frontier space since the Battle of Demeter. Militia's better organized now. More people join.
Multiplayer in this game is a lot of fun, but I'll be honest, I'm not super great at it. I do pretty decently, I feel like. is never I'm able to get usually top three pretty consistently, but it's not easy by any means at all. Quite difficult, to be honest. A lot of players are already pretty damn good at it, so that doesn't make it any easier.
Load your weapon.
Okay.
Get more precision.
Like this kind of gun, I would never use in multiplayer because I'd probably get my ass kicked. The people move so quickly.
Good. Practice more if you want, then head to the gun. Alright, got a new gauntlet for you to run today.
Let's do it.
Our time is 2 minutes. Follow the ghost or find your own path. Violets have to strike a balance in combat. Speed is paramount. Also hit your targets. The gauntlet is where we practice those skills until they're second nature.
Should probably wall run on that one. Seriously? Get out of the way. That's pretty decent, I guess. Not that great. I think it was better than my first time, whenever I went through. Oh shit, no. Screw that, I don't want that again.
Everyone has different strengths and weaknesses. Make sure to run this a few times with different weapons. Look at the results board for more tips on how to improve. Now that you're warmed up, if you want a real challenge, you can race against other pilots.
No, I'm just ready to move on. Do this.
Pilots who recorded these ghosts are the best in the SRS.
Anderson is a character from the main game.
On your way to being a real pilot.
Lastimosa 35. Gauntlet
as much as you want. When you're done,
that's him right there. Alright, over here, I think? Right there. I'm done.
All done with the gauntlet?
I'm ready to see what's next.
Good. You're gonna like this. Time to learn the other half of being a pilot. A Titan. Let's go call one in.
Hell yeah, let's do it.
Now, aren't pilots the only ones allowed to do that?
It's only a simulation, rifleman. It's not the real thing. But first, we're gonna need a little more space.
Wheat.
That's partner BT. He's a Vanguard class. Homegrown militia technology. First Titan chassis we designed ourselves.
Hello, BT.
One we didn't have to steal from the
Let's just say that us and BT are going to get to know each other very soon.
On your first Titan. Look up to the sky. There he is.
It's a bird. It's a plane. It's a Titan. Oh, just kidding.
All right, rifleman. Sounds like it's about to hit the fan. I'm pulling you
JK.
Out.
JK.
Powering down all non-essential systems.
Cooper, ready up.
Easy, Cole. You just left VR. He needs a minute to decompress. He'll be ready to go. Trust me.
Yes, sir.
Heads up. They're killing us. Trying to, anyway. Good session in there. You'll get the hang of it someday. We'll make a pilot out of you yet, rifleman. But not today. No time.
Lastimosa.
Anderson?
You son of a bitch. See you down there.
We're gonna see a new planet today. Maybe even die on it.
Let's always try and share some interesting tidbits from my life.
See
as a
you down there, rifleman.
This week I get to go Good to luck. A pretty cool training. It is a 2-day training, Thursday and Friday, and then I also go back in 2 weeks to like do a follow-up training on a Friday. So pretty exciting there. We're gonna do master. But basically it's for a specific like therapy intervention called PCIT, parent-child interaction therapy. And basically it's about kind of teaching parents in a way like how to interact with their kids and have like healthy boundaries and like healthy play with their kids. And see, a lot of parents don't really get that or understand that. So really in some ways you're almost teaching parents how to be nurturing and effective parents to their kids in like a few different ways. So I'm pretty excited about that. It's a very small training, but it's also really expensive. It's like $400 training, but I didn't have to pay for it. Work paid for it, so I'm really excited about that. And yeah, I'm just really, I'm pumped for it. I'm ready for this thing. It's gonna be awesome. Anything that makes me better at my job, or better at what I do, is something I definitely wanna get in on. I also have a birthday coming up soon, November 8th, which if you're here in the US, that's fucking election day. You know, I never realized that my birthday was on election day until this year, but it's such a fucked up election cycle. I'm like, holy shit, I have to fucking have my birthday, my 28th birthday, on fucking election day. I'm like, fuck my life, right? See, I'm not really too excited about that, but if you are some rich person out there who wants to, like, I don't know, buy me a Steam wallet card or something for my birthday, I would not stop you. November 8th, or put it on your calendar. It's also the day that we get a new president. God help us all. Or Xenu help us all. Allah help us all. Buddha help us all. Fucking, I don't know what else. Zeus help us all. Eternal nothingness help us all.
Are we near the drop zone? We are way off target.
Robots are kind of stupid. Shit. They're trying to kill us, what they're trying to do. Hello. Try not to die right now, Lastimosa. Damn. Grab this thing. This is my weapon for multiplayer right here. We got them all. Whoa, hello. Stomp. Oh, hell yeah, here we go. Boom, headshot.
Cooper, you're in bad shape. Hold on. This might knock you out, but you should be okay when you wake up.
Lastimosa, hostile titans inbound. Apex predators.
Copy that, BT. Mercenaries. Stay down, Cooper.
BT, let's go.
Oh, hell yeah. Got him. Got him. Oh, right in the back. This is what I don't understand right here. Like, you guys are going to see here in a second. But I don't understand that whole scene right there. And I'll point it out whenever we get to it. Cuts off his ear, I'm pretty sure. I think that's what he took anyways.
We have 18 hours. 18 hours until the Ark is sealed and ready for delivery. Oi, Richter! Leave the corpses alone, you sick bastard. We've got a job to do, eh?
I think he was in the first game. I could be wrong about that. But I'm pretty sure Blisk was in the first game. Maybe not. I think he was, though. His voice is incredibly familiar. If he wasn't in the first game, then someone who sounded just like him was. Uh-oh, about to get eaten. But wait, just then... I like how that body just kind of like floats downstream, if you guys saw that. I wonder where that thing went to. I think it disappeared. Hello, BT. See, this whole little bit makes no sense to me, right? So he's inside of it, so I guess maybe he takes, like, I don't know, body trauma or something from getting knocked around inside of the cockpit. But see, also, the Titan got punched in the back. So, like, I would think that that would do some serious damage to the back of the Titan, right? Getting punched in, like, the spine of the Titan thingamabobber. You know, I would think that that would really cause some problems, but apparently it doesn't. We'll see here in a second. The Titan's just fine in the back. Except it's like out of batteries, apparently. So, yeah. Kind of weird. Alright, so we skip ahead and we have buried Lastimosa under a bunch of rocks. It's a very nice way for someone to get buried, you know? I would at least dug a hole first and then put him under there, but I guess that's not an option right now. Right, Titanfall 2, ladies and gentlemen. I should say probably gentlemen and maybe one lady. Now here, check this out right here. See, no damage at all in the back. You would think, considering that like that punch took it down, there'd be some serious damage here, but no, apparently not. So yeah. I mean, it's still a good game. Just kind of annoying, I guess, in that way. I also like how the weapons that you pick up, they transfer between levels. So, like, if I pick up, say, a DMR on this level, it's going to transfer to the next level, which I think is really awesome. It's a nice touch because, you know, some games, it's like your weapon changes at the beginning of every single level that you do, but not on this one. You know, it stays consistent, which makes sense. Makes sense because, you know, obviously you probably wouldn't change your weapon between missions or whatever. I don't know why he didn't tell me to go get the battery. I think that's kind of strange. Because I'm pretty sure that when I did this the first time through, he told me to go get the battery. But basically, we have to get two separate batteries because BT is out of energy, so he needs energy. BT is that robot back there, by the way. Again, not sure why it didn't tell me that. Why that little detail was left out. Oh, shit. Hope that works, too. Shit, like bounce all over the place. Get away. God damn, that was weird. Alright, try this again. Those are just like a collectible, basically. Nothing super important. I guess I could see some crazy parkour. Hardcore parkour, right? You see the world's very beautiful here. Looks really nice. Again, I'm not sure why BT's not talking to me. Because the first time through, he was like kind of talking to me the whole time. I'm not sure why he's not doing that this time. You think it's true? I'm a Texas. Shit. Shit. Kind of a little close there. Be one more guy somewhere, I think. I definitely want the DMR here. DMR is pretty sweet. More flatline ammo. Be happy to take that. Shit. Forgot about them. Easy every time. Oh, you can hack Spectres? That's pretty sweet. Kicked it in the face. If robots had a face, right? This will keep the DMR out. You were brave enough. Flatline ammo, baby. Alright, so here's one down. I don't know why the robot's not talking to me. Like, this is really stupid. He needs to be talking to me. Like, Cooper's not talking at all. BT's not talking at all. I don't understand. Like, this is a really big part of the game. Is it because I'm on Master? I wonder if that's why. Maybe because I'm on Master difficulty. But that's so stupid. Like, why would it take out the banter if you're on a high difficulty? I don't understand. Makes no sense to me at all. I might have to try and investigate it for the next, next level. Alright, let's see if he talks to me when I get back.
Power low. Insufficient.
Okay, now he's talking a little bit. We'll see what happens now. Maybe I'm just moving too fast. I need to like stop and smell the roses. Alright, talk to me.
Power at 2/3. Data core reinitialized. Ocular system online. Adjusting focus. Are you all right, pilot?
I think so. Wait, did you just call me pilot?
Yes. The late Captain Lastimosa gave you the provisional rank of acting.
Okay, maybe
pilot.
He didn't talk to me for that first
Congratulations
bit.
Congratulations on
game.
Your promotion.
Maybe I'm just like
you
smoking
may call
crack.
Me BT.
BT.
Okay, just kidding. Never mind.
My systems are rebooting, but a third battery will accelerate the process. I will remain here.
Alright, next battery. It's this way, I think. Beep, 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 beep.
Until I am mobile, I will assist you through your helmet radio when possible.
To all militia personnel, the IMC will grant safe passage back to the Angel City Penitentiary. To all who surrender, it would be wise to turn yourselves in for the IMC search teams immediately.
Pilot, I advise against turning yourself over to the IMC. Voice pattern analysis indicates they are lying.
Don't worry, BT. I'm not going anywhere.
Understood, but I do recommend you move. IMC salvage teams are not far away.
I mean, I'm not leaving.
It is a common requirement for pilots to maneuver in situations without a linked Titan. Pilot, my mapping systems have been restored. The ambush of the 9th Militia Fleet has landed us far off course from our original destination. We are located in hostile territory. Be careful, we cannot stay here long.
How long did you serve with Lastimosa?
Captain Lastimosa linked with me 973 days ago.
That's longer than any relationship I've had.
I know there are militia survivors out there. Find you and we will track you down one by one. I ask you to come out of hiding while you still can. We have IMC search teams everywhere. Resist capture.
Oh hell. That hurt. Ow. Fucking shoot this guy. Jeez, my aim is off. Holy crap, that hurts. I keep forgetting I have cloak, but cloaking is just so cheap. It's really annoying. Dead. Okay, I guess we are ready to go. Punched him in the back of the face. Killing me today, guys.
Your suit has an emergency cloaking ability. This can help you survive dangerous situations.
Come on, jerk. I like how they keep on fire, like where you last came up at, they keep shooting at that area. It's kind of interesting. Oh god, don't shoot me. Shit. Yeah, that was bad. Should probably just thrown a grenade out there and not dealt with it. But, you know. Yeah, next time we're gonna throw a grenade. There we go, that takes care of him. Hemlock.
BT, is there anyone alive on this ship?
No. Scans do not detect any life signs within the MCS James McCallum.
That sucks.
But 90% of the lifeboats have been ejected. There is still hope.
BT, who is this voice?
This is the commander of the Marauder Corps, a section of the...
I did that last time, sooner I played this level, tried to go inside that little, upper area.
And there was all. To fight shoulder to shoulder, so that we may all enjoy a life on the frontier, free of oppression.
Low fire. Ah, yes, a fresh battery for my lovely Titan. Alright. Got it.
To all militia survivors, it would be in your best interest to turn yourselves in. Surely you would agree it is better for our infantry to fight you first, rather than...
Shut up.
Pilot, our location has been compromised.
Where you at, guys? Is that double? Almost a double. Move in. I see you there, buddy.
Those
anybody else want some?
IMC scouts. Enemy reinforcements will be on their way. We must complete the Neuralink immediately.
Oh, yeah.
The final battery. Power at full capacity.
Hey, buddy. Let's get some ass.
Pilot, we must establish a neural link in order to proceed.
Let's do it.
Please embark when ready.
It looks awful crammed in there. Cooper, Cooper, Cooper.
Protocol 1, link to pilot. Establishing.
It's like some Optimus Prime shit right here, you know?
Neuralink established. Rifleman Jack Cooper, you are now confirmed as acting pilot of BT-7274.
I am Optimus Prime.
Protocol 2, uphold the mission. Our orders are to resume Special Operation 217. Rendezvous with Major Anderson of the SRS.
Uh-oh.
Incoming enemy forces.
We're getting shot at, boys.
Protocol 3. Protect the pilot. Reinitializing critical systems. Vortex shield online. The vortex shield catches incoming rounds and missiles. Release the button to launch any captured objects back at the enemy. Shoulder-mounted rocket pod will lock onto multiple enemy targets. The longer you hold down the button, the more locks you will achieve.
And you did.
Neuralink complete. Primary weapon control and motion link reestablished.
Hell yeah.
Enemy Titanfall detected. We will have to fight our way to safety.
Oh, they're gonna die.
Get ready.
Great. Just gotta kill a few bad guys.
A positive attitude can only improve our situation.
Hello.
Militia Titan spotted. Chassis number BT-7274. Taking fire. Not bad, pilot. Not bad.
guy's being a little tough to take down.
Well done, pilot. Our combat effectiveness rating has increased.
We leveled up, boys.
Pilot, I detect more IMC salvage teams on the way. Our only chance of survival is to uphold our mission of rendezvousing with Major Anderson. Until then, you and I are on our own. Marking your HUD.
Get out of here, guys.
We must move quickly.